We're interested in deriving the Van't Hoff equation that shows how the equilibrium constant for a chemical reaction depends on the temperature. And so we want to start out with the relation between the equilibrium constant, Ka, and the change in the Gibbs free energy standard state over RT. So let me label these so we're clear what we're looking at in this equation. Well, we can see Ka depends on temperature because there's a temperature in the denominator and because delta G depends on temperature. And so let's calculate how delta G depends on temperature. So an expression that derived elsewhere results from first law and definitions. And we won't re-derive it here. This tells how Gibbs free energy depends on temperature and pressure. And because this is an exact differential, that means this term here is the partial G respect to T, this variable here, keeping this variable pressure constant. The partial of delta G over RT, because that's going to be our equilibrium constant with a minus sign, how that changes with temperature and at constant pressure. So I'm not going to keep writing, as you'll see, it'd just be easier. I'm going to make a note that we're doing this at constant pressure. And to do this calculation, we're just going to apply the product rule, which means let's take one term, 1 over RT, and then the partial of delta G respect to T, again, constant pressure. And then we'll take the other term, delta G T, times the partial of 1 over RT respect to T, again, at constant pressure. Now I'm going to use what we developed here to simplify. So the partial of G respect to T at constant pressure is minus the entropy. So this term, first term, is going to become minus delta S. In the second term, we differentiate. Of course, R is constant, so let me put R here. And I end up with minus 1 over T squared. So next, I'm going to substitute for delta G in terms of its definition. So let me just pause and put in that term. So I've made the substitution for delta G in terms of delta H and delta S. And let me do one more simplification of this term, of this equation. And we notice the first term and the third term are identical but opposite signs, so they cancel out. And we end up with minus delta H T zero over R T squared. So that says the change in the Gibbs free energy. But remember, this term on the left is minus log of the equilibrium constant. And the right, just going to write this down again. So this is the Van't Hoff equation that we wanted to derive. And this allows us, if we know delta H as a function of temperature, if you remember from the idea of state functions, we can calculate delta H at any temperature. If we know delta H at one temperature, like standard conditions, we can calculate delta H at standard state and at 298 Kelvin because we have tables for that. And then as long as we have heat capacities, including heat capacities that are function of temperature, we can calculate delta H as a function of temperature. However, sometimes it's not a bad assumption to assume that delta H is a constant, standard state. And if it's a constant, then we can just rearrange this equation and integrate it. So I've written this, remember, at constant pressure. I canceled the minus signs and I'm going to integrate from T1, where the equilibrium constant is K1, to T2, where the equilibrium constant is K2. Well, the left side just becomes the log of K2 over K1. And the right side, since delta H is a constant, delta H and doing the integration, with a minus sign for an integration from t1 to t2. And so then the log of equilibrium constant at two temperatures is just related to constant value for heat of reaction, 1 over T2 minus 1 over T1. So this equation we often use is certainly simpler, and it's not a bad approximation. And I'll demonstrate that by looking at a plot of the log of the equilibrium constant that was calculated using the heat of reaction being temperature dependent. I did this calculation for ammonia formation, log equilibrium constant versus 1,000 over temperature. And then I've just drawn a straight line through the values of the equilibrium constant, calculated at different temperatures. This is over 400 Kelvin temperature range. And you can see the straight line really fits the data quite well. So this is not a bad approximation for many reactions. And this is one that's often used because it's certainly so much easier to use. But it shows that the equilibrium constant can change dramatically with temperature if you look at how different the values, remember just the log of K that we're plotting here. So the equilibrium constant really changing significantly over this range.